Good morning, student. This is our part 8 video for the class 6. And the chapter which we are studying is element compound and mixture. Okay. So in this video, we have to learn about the mixture. We have to learn what is mixture in science. Then we have to learn the difference between the mixture and compound. We have to learn what is the type of mixture. What is the type of mixtures, and then in detail, what are those mixtures? An example also. Then the next we have to learn that characteristic of mixture. So how you can identify whether a particular given substance is a mixture or compound. Okay. So these things we have to learn in this video. So let's start. You can see in the screen what are the things which you have to learn. Okay, student. After that, as the chapter will complete, you can see in the screen I have given the homework also. The homework is 5 homework I have given. Define mixture. Number 2 is write 4 characteristics of a mixture. Then number 3 is how many type of mixture are there. Name it. Question number 4. Explain type of mixture and give example for the same. Number 5. Differentiate mixture and compound. Okay. So understand it better, whatever I am going to explain, so that you can write whatever the answer is given. Question is given and you will able to understand it. Okay, student. So let's move to the understanding part. So students, we have to study the mixture, right? So what is mixture? Mixture is a substance which consists of 2 or more elements. Okay, we have learned about elements. So either it should be 1 or a 2, or more than also, more than 2 also, or it may be a element or compound. But what will happen here? Not chemically combined together. Means in a mixture, there may be 2 elements, more than 3 elements, more than 3 elements, but their combination will not be chemically. So how it will be combined then? If 2 or more elements are there, or it may be compound, then their combination will be physically. Physically means you will mix with a hand. No use of chemical here. Right? Example, salt solution. Now, if you remember, what is salt solution? It is water and salt. So, are we using any chemical method here? No. Only we are adding water and salt with our hands. So, this is the physical process. Right? Then the next is common salt. The salt which you eat. This is a what? Sodium chloride. Sodium chloride and water. This is actually one example. Okay. So salt solution means water and salt when you add, that is salt solution. Next is air. Air is also a mixture. In the air, hydrogen is also there. Carbon is also there. Oxygen is also there. Nitrogen is also there. Right? helium and many many dust particles smoke, but they are physically combined. We don't need any chemical method to separate oxygen, nitrogen. But you are taking oxygen, right? For breathing, you need oxygen. Do you need any chemical method to breathe? No. Why? Because that is a physical method they are combined with. And they have their own property. They does not lose their properties. Okay? Similar with sugar solution, milk. Milk is also a mixture. And it is a mixture of what? Water. And then so many things that no need to understand here in this class. But it is also a mixture. Sea water, you know that water plus salt. Blood also have different components. And then components can vary. It's not fixed. So that is why blood is also a example of mixture. Then river water, muddy river water, that is also the example of mixture. Flour and water, the flour by which you make chapatis and all, you mix flour and then water, that is also the example of mixture. So what we have learned in mixture? Mixture is a substance by which it is made up of either two or a three or more than three elements or compound also, but combined physically, not chemically. Okay, I hope you understood. Then next is characteristics of mixture. So how will you identify what are the features of mixture? So first is, mixture shows the property of the constituents present in it. As I said above, that air. Example is air. So air retain its property. So in the mixture, you can mix two or three things, but all the things should retain their property. They will not change their property, right? As we have learnt in compound, that they will change their properties, but in mixture they will not change their properties. Okay. Then the next is, can be separated into constituent by physical process. It is made up by physical method. It is made up. We have learnt here, not combined chemically. If it is not combined chemically, obviously we can bifurcated, differentiated by physical method. So the second difference is, in a mixtures can be separated by a physical process. Okay. Then third one, as we have learnt in compound, that the proportion is fixed. But in mixture, they can combine in any proportion. Like if you have to make lemon juice, like the example of lemon juice, okay, or what you say, sharbat, your mother has said to make it, or your madam has said to please give me a lemon juice. So what you did, you added water, then salt, then sugar, and then lemon. But that ratio is not fixed. That how much you will give the lemon, how much you will give the salt, whether you will give the salt also or not. Because some of the person like to add pinch of salt, but not all. So the second thing is added in any proportion. It is not fixed proportion. Okay. Then next is, does not have definite boiling melting point and boiling point. Obviously, when their proportion is not fixed, how the MP and BP will be fixed? So, it does not have definite melting point and boiling point. Okay. Now move to the next thing. I hope this is only four characteristics. Does not have fixed BP and MP. Any proportion separated by physical method. Then it shows the property of constituent elements. Shows the property of constituent elements. Can be separated by physical method. Any proportion and does not have definite MP and BP. That much points only if you remember, then you can explain it, elaborate it. Okay, so the next thing which we have to study is the type of mixture. So how many types of mixture are there? Mixture are of two types. Homogeneous mixture. See here written in the screen. Mixture is of two types. Homogeneous mixture and heterogeneous mixture. So student, I am giving you the trick to learn. Homo means same and hetero means different. Homo means same and hetero means different. Okay. So let's move to the detail now. Those mixture in which its component are completely mixed and cannot be differentiated from one another. So means in homo means same. So sugar solution, salt solution. When you take a glass of water and you add a pinch of salt in it continuously, when you will drink, you cannot differentiate that this drop of water contain much salt and this drop of water contain less salt. You cannot compare it, right? So that is homogeneous mixture. Homo means same. Their constituents are same. You cannot bifurcate it. So this is homogeneous mixture. Those mixture which components are completely mixed together with same quantity, you can say, and which you cannot differentiate, that is homogeneous mixture. Okay, homo means same. So the mixture will have same constituents. Then hetero. Hetero means different. Let's take the example of sugar and sand. You have a bowl of sugar and bowl of sand. When you will mix it, then also it will not be have a same. When you will pick it up, a drop, a spoon of sugar and sand, then you cannot say that their constituents are mixed thoroughly. Their elements are mixed thoroughly. So, those mixture in which its components separated and one substance can be easily distinguished from other is sugar and sand. In homogeneous mixture, we cannot distinguish, we cannot differentiate. But in heterogeneous mixture, we can differentiate it. That given particular substance is not having a thorough combination, a thorough constituents. So that is hetero. Homo means same, hetero means different. Homogeneous, heterogeneous. Understood? Okay. So now we reach to the last topic, that is mixture and compound. We have already learnt about the mixture and compound. So this is only the small recap. Okay. So what? Let's move to the compound first. It is combined chemically. We have learnt that compound. We have learnt that compound is chemically combined. We cannot differentiate it. Right? Example, water. We cannot differentiate. We know that water is made up of two elements, hydrogen and oxygen. We know that compound is made up of two elements, hydrogen and oxygen. But can you, by taking the water, can you differentiate? Yes, this constituent is of hydrogen and this is of oxygen. No, you cannot. Why? Because they are chemically combined. So one feature we have learnt is chemically combined. Compounds are chemically combined. Example is water. In the same way, mixture, they are not chemically combined. Example is air. I have explained to you that water cannot be differentiated, but air has a nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, dust particles, smoke. So they are not chemically combined. Okay, student. Then next is, can be separated by physical method. Right? So we have the salt solution, sugar, shan, iron, sulfur. So in the mixture, what will happen? We can differentiate different parts by hand, by physical method. Right? But in compound, cannot be separated by physical method. So one point is, can be separated by in mixture, can be separated by physical method, and compound cannot be separated by physical method. Okay, the next is mixture. One more point left. This is the last point, student. In a mixture, the composition is not fixed. Here is composition is not fixed. So you can write it here, not fixed composition. In composition of mixture, it is not fixed. But in compound, it have fixed composition. Because in compound it has a fixed composition, so fixed MP and BP. MP is melting point and BP is boiling point. As it is fixed composition, so fixed MP and BP. But in mixture, the constituents are not fixed. So not fixed composition. So not fixed boiling point and melting point. Here also not fixed. Okay, student. So that's it today. If you could not understand, see the video once again and do the homework. Thank you.